Hey guys, I'm Lisa from the Chocolate Carousel. Thanks for joining me on live today. You know, everybody's got these great gardens going this summer, and one of the things that grows very plentiful in everyone's garden is zucchini. So I started thinking, what's something fun we could do with zucchini, and how can we use it in a baking recipe? And I came up with this great zucchini lemon cake or bread recipe. I'm not a huge fan of zucchini bread usually, but this one with the lemon changes the game. It just is such a great combination of flavors, you're gonna wanna try this. So let's get it started. Star of the show, we got a beautiful zucchini. If you're not growing these in your garden, you can find these at farmers markets and locally grown this time of year, and they're really delicious in all kinds of recipes. But this is a little different because we're gonna use it to bake. And also with this recipe, there's a lot of healthy ingredients. We're using extra virgin olive oil, almond milk, eggs, cake flour. It's a really nice, healthy recipe. So first we have to start by preparing the zucchini. And I'm just gonna cut off both ends and discard those. And then cut the zucchini right down the center, because it's much easier to work with if it's flat. So by cutting it down the center, you get two flat sides, and that makes it much easier to cut. And I'm just gonna cut this up into pieces so that I can put it into the food processor. So there's really no, definitive way to do this. I just wanna make it a little smaller so it's easier to go in the food processor. One large zucchini like this will work. It's plenty for this recipe. And I'm gonna dump this right down into the food processor. Let's go this way. I'm gonna start with half. Get it going. You just want to chop it up. Once I get that part going, I'm going to add the other half. Just right in there. You want to wash that beforehand, by the way, because we're using the skin in this recipe. So there's a lot of vitamins and nutrients and flavor in the skin, so we want to use it. So you just want to wash it before you start. Sometimes you have to pulse to get the bigger pieces down to the bottom and the little pieces out of the way. All right, once that's all chopped and starting to move freely, you're probably there. Let's take a look. Yeah, no big pieces. This is what it looks like right now. Nice, and you get that really pretty green color in there. Remove your blade right away. Trust me on this one, I've learned the hard way. You don't want to be reaching in there when you have the blade in there. So remove your blade right away and get it out of the way. We don't need that. We'll come back to that later. I'll put these with it. There we go. All right, so this is going to go into a container. You just want to put it in a container because we're going to strain out the liquid from this, but we're going to let it sit for a few minutes while we work on the rest of the recipe so that the liquid kind of separates from the vegetable. If you got a few big pieces in there, that's not a big deal. Russ, are you a zucchini eater?
I'm not.
You're not?
I'm not.
Or do you eat your veggies, Russ?
I don't.
It's very important to eat your veggies. If you eat a good, healthy diet with fruits and veggies, you can eat more cake.
I've heard.
Trust me on this one. All right. Well, we may turn you into a zucchini lover today. We're going to give it a whirl. You never know. We bake it with a little sugar and maybe it turns into something really good. Jeez. All right, so set that aside. And then we're gonna start with 2 cups of cake flour, 1¼ teaspoons of baking powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And you're gonna put that together in one bowl and using a whisk, just mix those ingredients, those dry ingredients together, and set that aside. Now in another bowl, separate bowl, 1¼ cups of sugar and 6 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. As soon as I found out that this recipe had olive oil in it, I was in, because it sounds so good. Lemon, olive oil, zucchini, and like I'm all over that. So get a good quality olive oil. You wanna make sure that it's got a nice flavor to it. And you're gonna add 6 tablespoons to the sugar. And this is a healthy fat, so we can feel good about this. Well, that was 4. Hope someone's counting. Started talking. I think talking and counting might be 2 different sides of the brain. I don't know, I kept count. whatever happened, it worked. Six. Six.
Close enough.
Six-ish.
That's six-ish.
Six-ish. All right, so we got six in there. Close the top. My husband says I don't close the top on anything, and it's always a big problem. So close the top, honey.
Marital bliss.
And then using your whisk, you're just going to whisk that oil into the sugar. And you'll see the sugar will get coated with the olive oil. Nice. Okay. So I'm going to transfer this now to a large bowl because I'm going to need space to put the rest of the ingredients together. So once you get that all mixed in and kind of tossed together, you get this pretty yellow sugar. It smells really good too. You smell that olive oil. We're going to add some wet ingredients to that. So 2 eggs and 1/3 cup of almond milk. We got our little farmer music going too. Really get, oh, Farmer in the Dell? Is that what this is? Farmer in the Dell. Love it! Bringing me back to my childhood. So I like to give the almond milk a shake. I don't know if that's necessary, but that's what I like to do. So that's what I'm gonna do. Adding 1/3 cup of the almond milk right in there. And then using the whisk again, I'm gonna bring this all together. And this will get nice and creamy at this point. Yeah, introduce a little zucchini into the recipe and we get farmer music. It's pretty fun. All right. Nice creamy consistency there. 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and 1 tablespoon of vanilla, lemon juice, never heard this version of this song, can't control these things, I'm not in charge of music, Russ, don't laugh, you'll shake the camera. All right, and your vanilla. Nice. Okay, get that all in there, and again, we're gonna give it another whisk. Just to have everything incorporated together. Okay, you start to smell the lemon right away as soon as it goes in there, and that smell just brightens up the whole thing. To that, we're gonna add that flour mixture. The flour, the salt, the baking powder that we had at the beginning. That's gonna go in now. And you wanna get that all mixed up together. So, it's folding that in. Just kind of having a little patience till it all blends. Just keep folding until it all comes together. It'll thicken up, become like a batter. You know, when I was making this yesterday, I started thinking, I bet you could make pancakes out of this at this point. It almost feels like pancake batter to me. So I would love to try it on a skillet. So if anybody does it, let me know how it works because that might be something that I'm gonna try. All right, any pieces of flour that you see, you're just gonna wanna smush those down and smush them in so you don't get lumps. Smush those out. There you go. Okay, got that all incorporated really nicely. So now we need to add the star of the show, which is the zucchini. But remember, we wanted some of that liquid to come out of the zucchini before it goes in because we don't want this to be wet. We wanna keep it nice and thick and control the liquid in the recipe. So we're gonna strain out some of this. And basically, just gonna go back over any bowl that you're not using anymore. And with clean paper towels,
just push down on the zucchini and let any liquid come out that may come out of the bottom. And you'll see, you'll get a bunch of liquid on your paper towel too. And do that a couple times to kind of get that dry. This one doesn't have that much liquid, so we're in good shape. A lot of it will absorb into the paper towel tip. It depends on your zucchini. Sometimes a lot of liquid will come out. All right, so once you get it drained out like that, we're gonna take 1.5 cups of zucchini and add it to this recipe. Okay, and then the zest of 1 lemon. So we want to add some brightness from fresh lemon in here. So I have a little mandolin here. If you don't have one of these, you can use a cheese grater. That works just as good. Don't grate the fingers, people, just the fruit. And you're just gonna get the zest off. There's a lot of vitamins in the zest and also a lot of flavor. You get a lot of lemony flavor from that. As soon as you start doing it, you'll smell it immediately. So a regular, you know, medium-sized lemon like this is gonna give you about 2 tablespoons of zest if you take the zest off all the skin. You only want the bright outside. As soon as you get to this white part of the lemon, you don't wanna dig any deeper because that's bitter. You just want that bright yellow outside of the lemon. And you can still use these lemons. Just keep them in the fridge once you've taken this outer skin off, but you can still use them in other recipes and dishes that you're making. Or put them in your water, whatever, don't waste it. All right, so I got that zested, and I'm gonna drop that down in there too. I wanna get it all, don't wanna leave that behind. Yummy yum. Okay, so I'm just gonna stir that in, and just at this point, I'm just folding to get that zucchini and the lemon zest evenly incorporated into the batter. All right, and at this point, you know, you're ready to go into your pan. So you're gonna use loaf pan for this. I have these nice paper disposable ones, or you can get the tin ones, the foil ones at the grocery store, which are great because cleanup's easy, which I love. Or if you have a regular loaf pan that you're using, make sure that you grease it first. With these disposable ones, you don't need to worry about that. And you're just gonna put your batter in, and you wanna go about 2/3 of the way to the top. All right, let's do this one. And you can see the pieces of the lemon zest in there. Of course, you can see the nice pieces of the zucchini. That just starts to look really good right from this point, and it smells really good too. Even Russ, who's not a zucchini lover, keeps nodding when I talk about the smell. So trust me, it smells really good too. You're gonna put these into a 350 degree oven, 45 to 55 minutes. Don't be fooled, that seems like a long time. I didn't believe it either, but it really does. It takes that time for it to bake all through and get nice and yummy. So pop that in the oven. I'll show you what it looks like when it comes out. And so this is what it looks like when they're done. You still can see the bits of the zucchini in there. You get the nice golden yellowy color from the lemon, and it's nice and soft and moist. We're gonna top this with a little bit of a lemon icing, which brings out a little more of the lemon flavor and just brings the whole thing together. So I'm gonna cut this lemon that I zested, and I'm gonna use this lemon for the lemon juice. And I have confectioner sugar here. This is about 2/3 of a cup. It's not really a precise measurement that you need here. I'm probably gonna end up with some extra, but I want to put it through a sifter because I don't want any lumps in my icing. Very important. So in the batter, it's a little bit less important because it's gonna bake out, but in the icing, I want it smooth. So So I'm gonna put this confectioner sugar, and this is 6 times, so it's already pretty fine. What you get in a grocery store is 10 times, but put it through a sifter so that you don't have any lumpy part. Patience, patience, patience. It's part of baking. Okay. That's probably enough for me to work with right now. Maybe not. Let's get a little more in there. Yeah, that's probably good. So to this, I'm gonna add a little bit of lemon juice instead of water. So as you might typically add water to icing, we're gonna use some fresh lemon juice. And just with a spoon, gonna stir that in so it becomes icing. And you'll know if you need to add more liquid. So if it's not becoming icing yet, and try not to get any pits in there, add a little more juice, okay? That looks about right. Really nice fresh lemon icing. It's just those two ingredients, sifted confectioner sugar and lemon juice. And this is what we're going to use to top these. And this just adds a little bit of sweetness and brightness to this recipe. This is one way to get your vegetables, people. My favorite way, actually. And it's a good way to get the kids to eat it, too. What do you think of that, Russell?
That's great news.
Okay, let's cut a piece. Look at that. Really nice. And you can just slice this. This is great for breakfast. It's a nice dessert. It's not overly sweet, but it has just enough sweetness to it. And then you get that really nice taste from the lemon icing and all that zucchini. That's all throughout there. The olive oil, which is a healthy fat. This is a healthy dessert. I love it when I come up with one. Guys, try this lemon zucchini bread, cake, whatever you want to call it, and post some reviews on my site. I'd love to hear what you think of it. And let me know if you make it into a pancake, because I think that would be really good. Thanks for joining me today on Live. It was great to have you with me. We have a lot of fun stuff coming up. We have a cupcake class next week, but guess what? It's sold out this morning. So if you want to come to one of our classes, sign up soon, because they sell out really quickly, and we're having a great time with all of the classes. Cake decorating coming up at the end of the month. You can check that out and look into it too. We have a challenge also the last week of July. Bring your team of four, compete against other teams. We have a really good time. We have a good theme for July, so you definitely want to get involved with that. And don't forget about Sweet Tooth Saturday, all you can eat, cake filling and frosting from 4 to 6. That is on the 15th, Saturday the 15th. So hopefully you'll join us for our Sweet Tooth Saturday too. We have a really good time. Thanks so much for joining me on Live today, guys. I will see you next Wednesday. Have a great week.